Annette Sperandio in account management, welcome. Remember when we interviewed?
Yes, I do.
What did you say?
Well, there were many things that were said.
Go ahead, I'm beaming it into you.
The one thing I remember is sitting across from you, the first thing was the Jaws poster, which
I thought,
yeah, I thought was a weird sign from my dad, because my dad's restaurant, as you know, was called Jaws in Eastchester. So, and he had a huge following once that movie came out.
Yeah.
But it was a Chop seafood house, and I was like, what the heck are the odds of that poster being on the wall right now? So yeah, so that was that. And then I just had like this feeling that you were going to take off. And I felt like that was a good fit for me because I was ready to take off with somebody and was ready to do the groundwork and to work up. Mm-hmm. So.
Well, that's a good jump off point. So where have we gone as a team since that started, since that day?
So 3 years ago, I joined the DBL Center in September. And we were in a small two office suite, and it was truly a mom and pop shop. And I was coming from a prestigious firm, and I was like, you know what, this is going to be a great opportunity. There was somebody here that was willing to grow, and we did just that. There was a trajectory set, and I said, tell me what I need to do and I'll do what I have to do. And we did just that, and in that we grew a database, from a statutory database to now being an ancillary and a statutory database. We took our knowledge together and we built upon something that your dad was very passionate about, you know, in his manual ledger. And you know, we added our tech savviness, if you will, to that whole process, from the audits to the processes to being able to create a portal to our carrier portals.
So explain that for a moment. So because you're in the day-to-day and handling, and we always say all the time, we're like, listen, you need me to be out.
Right.
You want me to be out. And I've been able to get out finally after 2 long years of what everyone's known and we've discussed previously. So now I'm out, and I say, when people call me up and they're like, what's line F on the garden app? I go, I have no idea.
Right.
I don't want to know.
Yeah.
That's her job. But that's good that you know that.
Yeah.
Sometimes it scares me that I don't know that, because God forbid you do move to Italy or something like that and cook, which we'll get into. I need to know what line F is on the Guardian app or the Principal app or any app. What's an app?
So we really started from the ground up, and that was mainly because I saw a lot of influx coming in from Rich's clients and your clients and even some of your dad's that were coming by the phone. Yep. And I was like, we really need to mainstream this, because we're doing, it's too much of getting in the weeds, too much getting stuck. And I knew that these carriers had the capability to do online portals and to make them really user-friendly for our clients and brokers alike. And aside from that, getting them these super access powers that allowed them to, you know, do employee terms and ads and address updates or, you know, retro terminations we still get involved with, but it's good to be needed, right? Mm-hmm. We want to be needed, but we also want them to be proactive on their own. So we took that information and we started to train our broker community.
Literally, and that's a good point, because don't you feel like for the first time, and I feel it, that we're in control? Not in a bad way, but it was sort of like we've formed the masses to sort of like a Pied Piper in a good way to get them to go somewhere, and they're using it. That function was missing.
Yeah, I think that there was definitely an opportunity for us as a team to show them that we now had a service model, and that service model was going to make the best use of the things that these carriers had been spending millions of dollars on, but so many people were not using. Now, does that mean we don't help out? No, of course not. That's, again, it's these are good problems to have, right? So we teach them. But then when they need us for something, it's because we know it's a true and blue issue.
Yeah.
So, you know, if somebody comes to me with a claim issue or a billing issue, listen, I printed the bill off the portal, but something's not right, it's not jiving, I still need you. And so in what you're saying, you know, do we have some control? Yeah, we're able to filter what happens first by giving them the access to do so. So we have up to 150 brokers, I think, at this time making use of it with two or more users on it. And a lot of them are, and we get such good positive feedback from it because they're able to do things that they would have to originally send an email to us, or then we'd have to send an email to our carrier, or even if they were reaching out to the carrier themselves, that was like at least a 7 to 10 day business turnaround.
And that simplicity internally shaves a little bit of time and fat off of everybody internally, which alleviates stress for us. And if we're less stressed, I think the clients pick up on that, the brokerage community.
I think that people can really feel it. Yeah, I think that people really rely on us to get things done. So like if you think about the sales process, hey, Mike, you know, they come to you or they come to me and work with you or whatever it may be. And they say, here's a census and this is what I'm looking for. You know, that's one process by itself. But then there's implementation, which is where I take the reins. And then there's servicing a case that's been finalized. So we have this tiered system in place, and they need to know where their pecking order is, and they rely on us to get it done within a certain amount of time.
And everybody's in their lane.
Yeah.
I always say that all the time.
Yeah.
And all of that in really 3 years, I would even say strong two.
Yeah. So when I joined the team, there was a start to a system, and it was really statutory based. And then I felt like the first 6 months of my being here, aside from learning the system, was changing over from our old system to the new one, mm-hmm. and then adapting and changing and tweaking. Mm-hmm. And we've done that for, I would say, well over 2 years to a point where now we're able to give it to our broker community, and we're able to share that with people so that they could see what we're bringing to the table. Because it's not just, hey, we're a general agency.
Sure, it's not just spreadsheeting.
No.
It's far beyond that.
Yeah, there's
That's the
service,
competitive advantage.
Yeah, exactly. There's service upon technology, upon being platinum status with our carriers. Mm-hmm. I mean, that in of itself, mm-hmm. we're able to leverage our relationships to get our broker and client alike.
And not going to too many.
All these different things.
It's not like 20 carriers.
Correct.
It's go ahead, say the number.
Right, so we have 7 to 9, realistically.
Okay. Including statutory.
Right.
But excluding 6, I was going to say.
Correct. You know, when I look at it, we're always looking to get them the best price. And so that's why I always try to go the 9 route, because if we are tacking on the DBL, or even if Lori's involved, or Eugene and Selena with the TDB, we're always trying to package. We're trying to get them the best rates and provide them the best service. And we know what the fit is based on what the client needs and what our carriers are able to bring to the table. So I think that we have such a strong feel for both our broker community and our carrier community that that's where we're able to make the recommendation.